Sapphire ColorFuse is a new color filter in Sapphire 2022. Let's see how we can finish the perfect color grade with Avid Media Composer and ColorFuse. Before we get into ColorFuse, let's take a quick look at the timeline here and just how the sequence has been edited. So we have a short spot here that's been broken up into a number of short scenes. And we have done, you know, the primary color correction. So all of the clips within the different short scenes match each other. And it's at this point where we're going to be using ColorFuse. ColorFuse is Sapphire's first creative LUT effect. And we're going to be using it to heighten up the color in the scene. So it's really is the final little bit of seasoning we're going to put on the scene to finish everything off. If you're not familiar with LUTs, LUT stands for lookup table. And it's basically a way of describing the transformation of different colors. This is often used when we're recording logarithmic footage on different cameras to try to squeeze as much dynamic range out of our data, to try and get as much useful color information out of our data as we possibly can get. ColorFuse doesn't deal with that technical side of things. We have another filter for that. If I come in here and type in OCIO, we have Sapphire's OCIO transform to transform things from log to rec 709 or to work in a linear sort of color space. What ColorFuse does, it lets us work with LUTs in a creative way. And we could apply this to individual clips, but I prefer to apply this to multiple clips in a sequence as a sort of filler layer. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to add a new video track up here and I'll apply over the top and just fill in on V2. And you see when we bring this up, we now get a different looking image. Let's scrub that through to find something that's a little bit more representative. If we take a look at the parameters in ColorFuse, the controls are actually very straightforward. I'll ignore the top of this for now, and I'll just get to the ones that are going to be the most interesting for us. It's our three buttons where we can input our three LUTs, and it's our three sliders. And those control the strength of the looks that we're mixing together. So if I wanted this to be a bit stronger, we've already got a LUT loaded in to the first position by default. So all I have to do is play around with our slider here until it looks right. If I want to change this up, I can press this little button and this will bring me into my LUT folder. Now ColorFuse ships with 30 different LUTs as part of the Boris FX LUTs starter pack. And these have a good naming convention. So we have CF for ColorFuse, BW for black and white film stock emulation, C for color film stock emulation, and S for stylized looks. So if I come down, we'll choose something in the stylized looks, maybe dystopian values, double click on that, and that will load that new look into the top LUT slot, and I can just then adjust that as I need to. Now I'm going to mix this quite hard because I want to show you one other thing before we move on. And that's the two drop-down menus that are just above. So we have host color space and LUT color space. And these are very important because you know how I said that ColorFuse doesn't really deal with those technical transformations. Well, that's not exactly true. To get your grade looking correct and looking the same between different hosts and between different projects, we are doing color transforms in the background. So your host color space should match what your project settings are. So we come into settings, I can see here that my color space is YCBCR709, so it's Rec709. And I can change my host color space from sRGB to Rec709. Let's take a little look at that skin. So I'm going to go from sRGB to Rec709. There we go. You can see there is a slight difference. Now the LUT color space lets us know what color space the LUT was designed to work in. Now, all of the ones that come shipped with ColorFuse are sRGB, so you won't have to change those. Now, with that being said, let's come in and finish up our look here. So I'm going to mix this down. I can come up to the top and bypass the effect to take a look at before and after. This is always very useful to be able to do, and you can do this with every Sapphire effect. Bypass the effect there. Much more important with color effects because your eyes do get very used to looking at certain colors. You stop seeing how strong they are at some point. But I'm going to come down now and choose my second LUT. And this one, I'm going to take one of the color film stocks. We'll go with the top one up here. And I can mix that back down. There we go. And if I don't like that one, then I can come in and maybe choose something else instead. So I'll choose the Kodachrome. I think that one's going to be better for me. Now, with all of these, subtlety can often be your best friend. You don't want to crank everything all the way up to one. Some of these are mixed a little bit strongly. So, you know, taking these down to just, you know, 0.2 or 0.4 is often going to be enough. You know, remember, this is going to be the seasoning that we're going to add. You don't have come in and made this delicious meal only to dump a huge amount of salt in at the very, very end. I'm trying to be a bit more subtle with it. Okay, so let's take a little look now at how that works in context. So we'll play that back. And it looks pretty good on this clip. But on this one, I don't know, I think we could maybe do with just lightening this clip up a little bit. So even though we've done primary color correction across this sequence, sometimes when you put on that final little look, you'll need to make a few small adjustments. So the nice thing about having this as a fill layer over the top is that if we need to make corrections to individual clips, we can still do that without any trouble whatsoever. So I'll just apply a color correction on there. I'm not going to do anything, you know, amazingly clever with this. I'm just going to bump up the gamma a little bit, and maybe we'll take the setup down just a wee touch as well. Come back to our filler, play that. Play that in context, because it's all about context, obviously. Yeah, that looks good. Yeah, I'm happy with that. If we look at this next sequence, I probably wouldn't use this same look to go over the top of this. I don't think it actually fits in with the scene. And again, this is another advantage for working with filler layers, is I can come in and just add edit points along towards the different scenes. And add another edit point. And I can deal with these different sequences as part of a sequence. And let's come over here, find somewhere. Again, it's going to be nice and representative. So it's Rec 709. And I'm going to go into my preset browser. In Avid, we currently can't preview the different presets in the playback window, but we can look at how they're going to look on our sample. And we also have descriptions of what they're going to do to your footage over on the side. And we have 50 presets that ship with ColorFuse. These follow the same basic naming conventions. So BW, black and white, C, color film, S, stylized. And we also have M, and M stands for mixed. So these are pre-mixed LUT cocktails that combine some of the different ColorFuse LUTs into one delicious drink. And these are named pretty interestingly. You know, there's a little bit of style to them, but you know, they do say what they're going to do. So, you know, cool defoliate, we know that's probably going to cool down the image and maybe take away some of the green there. Combat action, head into the war zone with this slightly desaturated, warm and subtly punchy look. So we do have good descriptions going up there. With this shot, I'm going to go with something like maybe cool defoliate or falling to autumn. Let's try that one there. And when I double click to apply that one, it's going to bring us back in, and I'll bypass that effect. And you can see the before and the after, before and the after. So this is turning our leaves a little bit more golden and desaturating us a little bit as well. And just because we're working from a preset doesn't mean that we have to stick with what the preset says. All of the controls are still editable. So if I think that this has gone a little bit too desaturated, I can see the top one of my LUTs here is BW, so that's black and white. So I can just pull that down a little bit. If I pull that all the way up, you can see that is black and white. So I pull that down a little bit, maybe just give us a touch there. If I wanted to get a bit more life into those trees, I'll take us from Dry County, and let's just turn the dry county down a little bit as well. So we've got the foliage just, you know, livening up a little bit more there. We'll come over to another clip just to see if that's working across the line. And I think that is, I think that's looking kind of nice. Always useful to do that just to bypass the effect, make sure it's working across. We'll just play that back, just see how that's working in context. Yeah, it's going to be nice. Okay, I'm going to skip over to our final clip here, or our final section, as I should say. I can see that this one also, you know, needs a different look than the one we had for our boxer at the start. So let's come into our effect. Let's reset all of this. Set our host color space back to Rec 709. Now, even though S-ColorFuse comes with 30 different LUTs, it doesn't mean that you have to use those. If you have your own that you've either created yourself or that you've bought from other places, then obviously you can use those too. I'm going to come back in and just replace my LUT 1. It's going to take me into my main ColorFuse LUTs folder, but I'm just going to navigate out into my own LUT folder. And these are external LUTs, my big folder of LUTs. All right, so let's come in into here, and I can use any of these non-bundled ones in ColorFuse as well. As long as they're .cube files, they're probably going to work. I'm going to use Ektar 100, and I'll add another one in to LUT 2. Maybe choose this one. It's kind of a bit too contrasty, so we'll just take the strength down on that. There we go. I think that one's looking a bit strong as well. And I'll choose a third one just for good luck. And this time I can use a regular ColorFuse one. I will choose Punchy Slightly Warm and take that down. Bypass the effect, see the before and after. Yep, that's looking nice. Let's come over here, check it out. Yeah, that works for me as well. Now, what I think is really, really cool about this is that now I've created my own look using a combination of ColorFuse LUTs and external LUTs. I can save this as a ColorFuse preset. So I'll just call this one Ben Big Blue Sky. And I can add in any little characteristics I want to down here, just as normal. And I can export this to a separate file to share between people or put onto a network drive, or I can just save this as a preset on my own computer. The advantage about doing it this way is that I don't have to keep track of where any of these external LUTs are anymore. All the data that I need is saved within that preset. So I can just save that preset, share it around, put it onto other machines, use it in other hosts that are working with ColorFuse, and I don't need to keep track of any other files. This avoids the problems of LUT files just suddenly going missing, going offline, and have to manually find them and relink them again. You don't have to do that anymore because everything is in that one file. And that really is all there is to it, to create some beautiful, unique looks using ColorFuse. You set up your sections, set up the host color space. I always like to start with a preset and then just get creating. And with that, you can use ColorFuse to heighten and enhance your image and create some truly unique looks with just a few clicks. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and I will see you again soon. If you enjoyed this and you'd like to learn more about ColorFuse, then please leave a comment below with any questions you might have. If you want to try ColorFuse out for yourself, then just head over to borisfx.com, where you can download trial versions of Sapphire and all of the Boris FX suite.